So Anthropic's a longtime AWS customer and one of the world's leading foundation model providers. Their models, Claude, and they got others as well, excel at a wide range of tasks from sophisticated dialogue and creative content generation to complex reasoning and detailed instructions. So as part of the collaboration, Anthropic is going to use Trainium and Inferentia to train future generations of their models. And Bedrock customers are going to have early access, not available in other clouds, to unique features for model customization and fine-tuning capabilities. So to dig in on what we're doing with Anthropic, I'd like to bring out our partner, Dario Amodè, who's the CEO and co-founder of Anthropic. Let's give him a hand. Great to see you as well. All right. Oh, we have chairs. Let's sit. Dario, thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, earlier we talked about how Claude is available on Bedrock, but before we get into that, let's just talk a little bit about what Anthropic is about and what makes Claude so unique.
Yes, so Anthropic was founded on the idea that we can make AI models that are safe, reliable, and steerable while still being highly capable. The founders of Anthropic were a set of people who worked at OpenAI for several years. We developed ideas like GPT-3, reinforcement learning from human feedback, scaling laws for language models, some of the key ideas behind the current generative AI boom. Seven of us left and founded Anthropic. Our foundation model, Claude, in addition to being safe and reliable, excels at a lot of knowledge work tasks like content generation, summarization, Q&A, complex reasoning, things like that. We have an industry-leading context window of 200K tokens, that's about 150,000 words, which makes it well-suited for areas like legal, finance, insurance, coding, things like that. And about half of the Fortune 500 are using or are testing Claude.
So amazing progress. So just a few months ago, obviously Amazon and Anthropic announced kind of an enhanced strategic collaboration. Anthropic named AWS as your primary cloud provider for mission-critical workloads, and you're going to be training and deploying future generations of Claude and foundation models on AWS. So just tell us a little bit about, from your perspective, what led up to this and how that relationship between Anthropic and AWS grew.
Yeah, so Anthropic's use of AWS goes back to our early history, back, you know, all the way in the mists of time in 2021.
Way back, remember that, right?
We've trained our first model on AWS, and so we're excited now to say that, you know, you guys are our primary cloud provider for mission-critical workloads. I would say the partnership has three components. First is the compute side, which I just discussed, which we've been doing, throughout our history. The second is on the provision to customer side. We're very excited to hear about Amazon Bedrock. We really recognize the value that we could provide to customers working together. And the third side is the hardware. We're currently working with you guys to optimize Trainium and Inferentia for our use cases and hopefully for other use cases. And we really believe that we can achieve that 4x faster than the first generation Trainium that you just announced, if we optimize these things together. And so putting together these three pieces, layers of the stack, really allows us to provide things to customers together that couldn't be provided before, things like customization of models, use of proprietary data, and unique fine-tuning features.
The respect we have for you guys is just tremendous. I mean, truly world-class expertise for the Anthropic team. I've really enjoyed working together, and the models are just so powerful. So obviously we are aiming to, and I think we're in the process of improving an incredible array of customer experiences through this collaboration. And of course, our own Amazon developers also have access to Anthropic models on Bedrock and throughout the company. And we're not only working to provide customers with this, but we're giving them early access to unique features that they're not going to be able to get anywhere else. And we're out there together with our Generative AI Innovation Center, working with customers in the field, helping them to actually get targeted. And that's allowing us, of course, to bring this expertise and the domain-specific expertise that they need to customize the models. And as we've been out there together, and it's been hot and heavy, particularly the past few weeks, but before that as well, what are some of the most interesting use cases that you've seen?
Yeah, so I'll give three examples across different industries. There's many others, but this should give a sense of the range. And we've seen a lot of organic adoption. One example in the biomedical space, we're happy to announce We're working with Pfizer. I'm a former biologist myself, so I'm really excited for, you know, any way AI can advance medical science and, you know, bring life-saving drugs to people around the world. In the legal space, we made a custom fine-tuned model, deployed it through you guys for LexisNexis to help with their legal search, you know, in a way that's kind of fact-based and produced citations. And in the finance space, we're working with Bridgewater Associates to develop an investment analyst assistant. Beyond that, you know, just some examples, we've engaged with 7 out of 10 of some of the largest players in the insurance and banking industries, and, you know, could tell similar stories about other industries. So, you know, we're excited to see new use cases and where all of this goes.
It's incredible momentum. I'm just the financial services example to be working with that many leaders. So just last week, you're not standing still, right? So just last week, you announced Claude 2.1. So that's got a whole lot of new advancements and key capabilities. Maybe you can tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, so Claude 2.1 really, you know, is a release that's targeted at enterprises. So a few different features. One is we've doubled our context window to 200,000 tokens. Tokens is a term of art in the AI space. What it amounts to is about 150,000 words, which is a relatively long book. And so use cases like reading financial statements, reading an entire long book, and one of my favorites, putting multiple documents in the context window and asking the model to compare them or integrate them. A second feature is that we've reduced the rate of so-called hallucinations, which is when models say things that aren't true, by about 2x. We've seen across the industry a core obstacle to deployment in the enterprise world is people are worried that models will say things that aren't true. No one has perfectly solved this problem, but we are really leading the way in getting more and more reductions. And then we also have some beta features. We're introducing system prompts, tool use as a beta feature, and a developer workbench. Again, all tools targeted at people building for enterprises. We're excited to see all the use cases that emerge from this.
I'm speechless. That is such incredible progress. You talked about the reduction of hallucination, a really important topic. You know, just more broadly, I think we share a belief that AI should be, you know, safe, secure, responsible, and benefit society. And we've been engaged in a lot of groups and organizations that are promoting the development and deployment of responsible AI. In fact, I keep bumping into Daria around the world at some of these various gatherings, which is nice. So I know this is a particular passion of yours, and can you tell us a little bit more about Anthropic's work in this area?
Yeah, I mean, you know, obviously this is something we were founded on and that we care about deeply. You know, I would categorize it into two areas where we've done work in this area. One is the way we design our own models, and the other is the way that we try to set an example for the ecosystem and bring others along so that ultimately everyone becomes safer and more reliable. So a large fraction of our research org works on safety. We put a lot of work into, you know, making our models hard to break, making them secure against misuse and harmful use. There was a recent study out of Carnegie Mellon where people tried to adversarially break different models, and it found that they were able to successfully break Claude 10 times less often than they were able to break the competitor's model. So there's a real difference here. Second, we've put a lot of effort into interpretability, seeing inside the models. There's no commercial deployments on that so far, but it's been a long arc, and I am hopeful that relatively soon, for both compliance and for understanding what models do and therefore reducing bad behavior from the models, we'll be able to make a lot of progress. On the wider ecosystem, you know, we always try to create a race to the top. Do something, and then competitors, other players in the ecosystem follow along and do the same thing. An example of this is a responsible scaling policy where we front-loaded safety investment ahead of model scaling, a kind of pre-deployment testing regime like what's done for cars and airplanes. And in the policy space, we've continually advocated for governments to build up their ability to evaluate and measure AI systems. If we're not able to evaluate and measure things, we'll get either no regulation or poorly informed regulation. We need to all work together to make sure that we can develop quickly, responsibly, but in a way that's secure.
I just love the concept of the race to the top. It's so positive. And what you're doing is so amazing. I mean, we've said in the whole 17 years that AWS has been providing services that you know, so much of what gives us energy is just working with, you know, the coolest, most cutting-edge, you know, startups and entrepreneurs in the world, and there is just no better example than what's happening in generative AI now and what Anthropic's doing. So It's great to be partnering together so deeply, and really appreciate you joining me here on stage today.
Yeah, excited for everything we can do together.
Thank you. All right.